Shall we pray? Loving Father in heaven, we humbly invite the presence of the Holy Spirit to fill this place and to fill our hearts. Father, we want to surrender all our tiredness, our cares, our worries to you, so that today, this wonderful Sabbath, it will be a meaningful one for the adults, the young people, and even the children. We commit this worship to you, that all that we do will give glory, honor, as we worship you in spirit and truth. Your name will be glorified, Lord, and this we pray in Jesus' most wonderful name. Amen.
For scripture reading, may I invite you to turn with me from this Pew Bible. Exodus chapter 8, verses 1, 25 to 32. Exodus, the book of Exodus, chapter 8, verses 1, and 25 to 32, I read. The Lord spoke to Moses, "Go to Pharaoh and say to him, 'Thus says the Lord, let my people go, that they may serve me.'" Verse 25. Then Pharaoh called for Moses and Aaron and said, "Go, sacrifice to your God in the land." And Moses said, "It is not right to do so, for we would be sacrificing the abomination of the Egyptians to the Lord our God. If we sacrifice the abomination of the Egyptians before their eyes, then will they not stone us? We will go 3 days' journey into the wilderness and sacrifice to the Lord our God as he will command us." So Pharaoh said, "I will let you go that you may sacrifice to the Lord your God in the wilderness. Only you shall not go very far away. Intercede for me." Verse 29. Then Moses said, "Indeed, I am going out from you, and I will entreat the Lord that the swarm of flies may depart tomorrow from Pharaoh, from his servants, and from his people. But let Pharaoh not deal deceitfully anymore in not letting the people go to sacrifice to the Lord." Verse 30. So Moses went out from Pharaoh and entreated the Lord, and the Lord did according to the word of Moses. He removed the swarms of flies from Pharaoh, from his servants, and from his people. Not one remained. But Pharaoh hardened his heart at this time also. Neither would he let the people go. May the Lord bless us as we meditate on these words. We are so happy today to have our Executive Secretary of the Southeast Asia Union Mission, Pastor Abel Bana, to break the bread of life for us.
Happy Sabbath, Church. Not sure if this is working.
Testing.
I'm so glad to be able to worship with all of you at Balestier. It's been, I think, about 1 month since I spent Sabbath with all of you. And I'd like to thank the church family for praying for my dad, who had a stroke, and continue to pray for him. I believe in the power of prayer. I thank you. I thank the pastor, Pastor Mark. Though I'm a pastor, but I also have a pastor here in Singapore who takes care of my family. And we are very thankful for the family here in Balestier Church. It is usually my practice to share before my message a short sharing of what's happening in our union country. Just one or two things that's happening recently, which is just one or two things that's been happening in our union country. For example, it's not really clear, right? Can the person at the back hear my voice? No, they cannot hear. So I use the mic. Testing. Okay, it's fine.
We want to praise the Lord that just last month, finally in the country of Vietnam, in Hanoi, we have our own building there, friends. Can we say amen to the Lord? It was a difficult task to finally get this building because it's not easy in a country like Vietnam. But today, we have a beautiful building in Vietnam, a place that people can find hope, a place that people can worship one day, a place that people can find activities that can bring them to Christ.
And friends, let's continue to pray for Hanoi, that more and more people will be able to find Christ and the truth through this center of influence. We want to continue to pray for our future mission office. This will be our new mission office in Vientiane, Laos. Hopefully it's going to be completed soon by God's grace. And this is going to be a place of worship for the people of Vientiane and also the headquarters for the Laos attached field in Vientiane. The title of today's message is Let Us Make a Deal. Can we pause for a moment for a word of prayer? Father in heaven, for the next few minutes, we'd like to surrender this place to you. We'd like to surrender our hearts to you. Hide me behind the cross of Jesus so that our members, all of us, will be brought nearer and closer to you. Oh Lord, whatever is of you, establish it in our hearts. Whatever is of me, help it, O Lord, to be quickly forgotten. We commit this day, and I commit my mouth to you and my heart to you. In Jesus' most wonderful name, amen. I was given the task to talk about Moses and Pharaoh today. It's okay? Testing, testing. Can the person at the back hear me now? Okay, wonderful. I was about 13 years old that time. 13, not 30. 13 years old, many, many years ago. And a senior classmate, a senior schoolmate came to me. He said, Abel, I had a dream last night. What was your dream? I dreamt of 6 numbers. There you go. This sounds like the Hung Pao lottery draw in Singapore. Yes? What about the 6 numbers? I said, well, what I want from you is I would like you to give me 10 ringgit and I will go to town and buy the 6 numbers. Oh, really? So what happened after that? If we win, he said, the deal is this. He's making a deal with me. We will divide that gift 50% and 50%. Wow. So the first prize, he said, you will win 100,000 ringgit if you are familiar with Malaysia. I said, that's quite a good deal. Why not? So I gave him 10 ringgit. And the next day, we were excited, patiently waiting for the result of the number. And unfortunately, the number did not come out, friends. I was a bit unhappy, but he was okay because he did not come out with the money. And friends, Pastor Mark, interestingly, 3 weeks ago, I was in Sarawak, and lo and behold, I met this friend of mine in the marketplace. And I said, wow, you remember what happened many, many years ago? Yes, he said. And guess what, friends, today? Today, he is a priest in a particular church, and today, I'm an Adventist pastor. It's interesting how the Lord transformed and changed through that deal many, many years ago. But today, we're going to talk about a different kind of deal when the Lord deals through Moses and, of course, Pharaoh is the one that represents the devil here, actually, in symbolically meaning. Let's look, and I appreciate if you can read this together with me. I know how busy we are sometimes. Let us find time to read. Because when you hear Pastor Mark read, just now perhaps it's lingering there. But when you read together with me, it's going to be better, friends. Let's read it together. 1, 2, 3. Then Pharaoh summoned Moses and Aaron and said, "Go sacrifice to your God within the land." But Moses said, "It would not be right to do so, for the sacrifices that we offer to the Lord our God are offensive to the Egyptians. If we offer in the sight of the Egyptians sacrifices that are offensive to them, will they not stone us? We must go a 3 days journey into the wilderness and sacrifice to the Lord our God as he commands us." So Pharaoh said, "I will let you go to sacrifice to the Lord your God in the wilderness, provided you do not go very far away. Pray for me." Then Moses said, "As soon as I leave you, I will pray to the Lord that the swarms of fowls may depart tomorrow from Pharaoh, from his officials and from his people. Only do not let Pharaoh again deal falsely by not letting the people go to sacrifice to the Lord." So Moses went out from Pharaoh and prayed to the Lord. And the Lord did as Moses asked. He removed the swarms of flies from Pharaoh, from his officials, and from his people. Not one remained, but Pharaoh hardened his heart this time also and would not let the people go. Friends, the Lord sent Moses to go to Egypt and to meet a king and to talk to a king, Pharaoh. And as you know, Pharaoh was enslaving the people of Israel at that time, and God wanted Pharaoh to let his people go. So Moses is given the task to talk to Pharaoh, but he hardened his heart, so God gave the plagues and made the people suffer, especially Pharaoh. But in that process, 4 times, brothers and sisters, Pharaoh wanted to let the people go, but he wanted to give them with a condition. Pharaoh made a deal. Pharaoh said, "You can go, Moses, but in one condition." 4 times in this situation, we're going to learn today, 4 situations where Pharaoh made a deal with Moses. Number one, deal number one, Pharaoh said to Moses, "Why don't you just sacrifice here?" Pharaoh is saying, "Let's make a deal here. You can serve your God, Sister Amelia, but don't leave Egypt. Continue to serve God, but maintain your worldly lifestyle. You can be a Christian still, in other words, but don't forget the world. Continue on." But Moses disagreed with this deal. Moses, sent by God, know that this is not a good deal, because that sacrifice, just imagine, the people of Moses and his people would have to sacrifice in Egypt, because Pharaoh asked them to sacrifice in Egypt. But the cow is a sacred animal for the people of Egypt. Just imagine if Moses and his people sacrificed cow, it would cause confusion and anger to the people of Egypt. Friends, let me tell you about our world today. The cross and the word Jesus is a very sensitive word to many people. Even the word Christianity is a very sensitive word to some people who are not Christian. Friends, Moses is not willing to sacrifice in Egypt at that time, because he knows it's going to cause a lot of problems there. Have you tried to talk to people about Jesus? I've tried many times in the car, in the taxi, and it's tough, my friends. because the word Jesus is a different thing in terms of the truth. Secondly, the second reason why Moses did not want to sacrifice in the land of Egypt, because that was not God's command. God says, get out of Egypt. Do not be there. Don't spend your time there. We have something for you. You need to go out from this place. Friends, today, the devil is telling us, you can be Christians, but you don't have to really follow the command of God. You can continue on what you like to do in this world. Continue to be Christians, but don't follow the command of God. I tell you, many, many years ago, when I was a pastor in the church, they invited me to conduct a wedding blessing on a Saturday night. I conducted the wedding blessing, and it was a happy occasion. And after eating the dinner, I went home straight. And the next morning, on Sunday morning, I went to the Sunday market. And few of the ladies said, Pastor, yes, ma'am. Thank God that Jesus did not come last night. I said, why? Because if Jesus came last night, many of our members would not be safe. I said, why? Why? It is my desire that the members will be safe. But he said, Pastor, thank God Jesus did not come last night. Why? Because what happened is that the moment you step out of that place, the moment that you went back to your house, all the alcohol came out. The loud music came out. And they were enjoying themselves until morning. Christians! I tell you, Christians, but that is not what wants us to do. God wants us to live a spirit-filled life, brothers and sisters, a life full of His heavenly blessing as we walk with Him. The greatest one of the world is the one of man, Ellen White said. Man who will not be bought or sold. Man who in their inmost souls are true and honest. Man who do not fear to call sin by its right name. Man whose conscience is as true to duty as the needle to the pole. Men who will stand for the right through the heavens fall. Education, page 57. The second deal that Pharaoh made to Moses is this. The first one, sacrifice in this land, just worship in Egypt so that we can see. Secondly, why don't you stay close by? Pharaoh is saying, let's make a deal, Moses. If you people must separate from Egypt, don't go too far away. Again, friends, this deal is offered to all of us here today as well. The devil is offering this deal to us today. The devil is saying, let's make a deal. Let's make a deal, sir. Let's make a deal, Janelle. Let's make a deal, Charlene. You go ahead and be Christians. But don't take it too far. Don't be too serious with your religion. Don't be too serious. Have you heard of that? Don't be too conservative. Don't be too radical as a Christian. You know, tell your pastor to so that his message will be sweet to hear, not the hammering type. Make your music in the church to be like the music of the world so that more young people can come. I tell you, as a pastor myself, I've heard these people say, Pastor, don't hammer too much. But you know, as a carpenter, hammer is very important. When you hammer things, the thing will be strong. The thing will stick together, friends. I tell you. Let's move to the next slide. Satan wants us to live our lives like the world around us. And he will say things like this. Listen, you cannot see it up there, but I'm going to read to you loud and clear. Be safe. No one can change that. Try not to stand out too much. Try not to be so different from the world around you. Go to church every Sabbath, but not more than that. Be safe if you want to, but don't talk about Jesus in your office.
Don't talk about Jesus in your school. Do the same thing. Don't dress differently. Have Jesus if you want him, but don't take these things to extremes. Don't be a radical follower of Jesus. This is the deal that Satan is giving. Like Pharaoh said, don't go too far. Just stay around here, Moses and your people. We love you. We like you. I like this, friends. We're going to the third deal. The first deal is that just worship here in Egypt. This is okay. Second deal, don't go too far. This is the third deal. Parents, very important. This is very important. I'm going to read this. I know it's very small. Pharaoh is asking and he's saying, worship your God, Pastor Mark. But he's giving a question, which one will go? Oh, Moses said, I will go. Our young people will go. The old people go. My sons, my daughters will go. But for Pharaoh, you can go, Moses, but let your young ones, let your wife, let your daughter, let your family members stay and continue to stay in Egypt and live in the world. Friends, the devil is working hard to break families apart. He's happy just one out of five, for example, be safe. But, you know, if you have five people in the family, if one is safe, four is unsafe. That is the devil's strategy. But he wants more and more families to break. Today, brothers and sisters, maybe tonight, husband and wife, it's time to spend some time to heal that problem, to heal that brokenness in that family. Perhaps today, our loved ones are not in church. I'm struggling too with some of our family members who are not at church, who knows about the truth but not in church. I want to pray that Satan will not win the victory over families, brothers and sisters. Fathers today, continue to lead your family. And I realize if mothers, if your father, your husband is not here, do your best to please the Lord so that God will continue to help your family. The deal number three is this. Why don't you just focus on yourself? Don't worry about your family. This is what Pharaoh is offering Moses, the deal. Moses, you can be safe. The leaders can be safe, but forget about the wife and the children, brothers and sisters. Let's make a deal, Moses. You can take the man and go serve God, but leave the rest of the family out of it. I want my family to go to that day. A couple of weeks ago, I touched the hand of my dad. I said the first thing when I reached the hospital, Dad, do you want me to pray? Yes. He said he cannot talk. He was on the stroke on the left brain and the right side is paralyzed now and it affects his speech. But as I pray the prayer of how my dad has led us as a family many, many years ago, and as I opened my eyes, I saw him cry. And I thank him to the many years brought our family through thick and thin, through difficulties, but make sure that we continue to be faithful until the end as a father. Friends, as we go to heaven, we'll go as a family. It's going to be challenging to be at the side of Lot in heaven one day. You know what happened to Lot, right? Yes. It's challenging to be by the side of Lot. Satan wants your family. That is the reality, brothers and sisters. He does want you to have a godly Christian home. He does not want you to control your children. He wants you to let them run wild. He wants you to leave all of life's decisions up to them, up to you, children. You decide. He wants you to let them find their own way. Last one. I'm going to spend some time on this. I used to be the stewardship director of Sarawak Mission. I want to share a little bit. It's very interesting, brothers and sisters, that the flocks and the herds during the time of Moses represent our possessions today. Pharaoh is saying and making a deal with Moses. Moses, let's make a deal. If you must serve God, go ahead and serve Him. But leave your possession behind in Egypt. Take yourself out of Egypt, but leave your money here. In other words, friends, go ahead and serve your God. Go ahead and worship God. But your time, your attention, your money, your possession must be for the world, in other words. Invest more. Enjoy the world more with your possessions and time. Can I know, friends from the Philippines, can I see your hands? Mga kapatid taga Philippines. Oh, so many of them. Many years ago, I was attending a baptism ceremony in the Philippines. And we were arranging people to get to the sea to be baptized. And then lo and behold, there was one man who was about to be baptized, and we saw him holding his wallet and putting it in his trousers and going to the sea. And the lady said, "Sir, please remove your wallet at the same time because it's going to be wet." And he said, "No, Pastor Abel, don't worry, because I want that my wallet be baptized together." I tell you, this is Philippines. The man do not want only to be baptized as an individual, but all his possessions belongs to the Lord. God do not want only how we deal with our 10%, but He wants us also to follow Him on how we deal with the 90%, brothers and sisters. The devil is smart. He knows how to capture you. He knows how to put your eyes into the attraction of the world. It's like what Pharaoh said, "Moses, leave your things behind. You go serve God." Friends, I've heard many times, they said, "Pastor, what the church wants from me is just my money." Let me share this carefully. I may hurt people here. The church don't need your money. Listen, I'm not finishing my sentence yet. It costs money to run the organization. The building that we saw, that we bought in Hanoi, costs over $1.8 million. It's a lot of money. Hanoi. But God, the church, wants the money of those who love Him. Listen. It is better not to give if you give with an unloving heart to the Lord. Yes, the church needs you only when you give because you love your God. Friends, it is sad. But many fall for this compromising of the devil in our day. If we are safe, there is nothing he can do about it. But if he can, he will try to keep all that we have invested in the world. We have to be like Moses and refuse to leave anything we have in the world. Ooh, that's interesting. Refuse to leave anything for this world, for Satan. Friends, God must have it all. He wants everything we have. He wants our time, our hearts, our talents. Thank you, Sister Amelia, for playing beautifully for the Lord. He wants the 10%, and He wants to tell us what to do with the 90. You know this story well. The Bible tells about two brothers, Esau and Jacob. Esau was the older one. And because at the time, if you're the oldest one, you will get double portion of the property of the father. Whew. Can I see the eldest here? If you are all the eldest in the family, can I see your hands? Lawyer, it's nice to be the oldest sometimes. Double portion. Double portion. And Esau worked in the field, and he was tired. He came home. And there, lo and behold, he was hungry. He saw the soup, the lentil soup made by Jacob. He said, "Jacob, Can you share me the soup? I want to drink it. Jacob said, huh, let's make a deal. Let's make a deal, Esau. I give you the soup. I tell you, I love this couple. Wonderful. I give you the soup. Take the soup. But, oh, don't take it. Don't drink it yet. I give you the soup, but the deal is this. You give me your birthright. He was hungry. I tell you, when you're really hungry, you tend to order a lot of things, and at the end of the day, you cannot finish it, right? Oh, I want that, I want this, I want that. But when everything comes, you can finish only some. And Esau was hungry as well, and Jacob made a deal with him. You want the soup? Give me the birthright. Without thinking, without studying the matter carefully, he let go something not as precious as the birthright, and he lost it all. Brothers and sisters, today, I want to tell you, many of us gone through this. Every day, every time, the devil is making a deal with us. And sometimes we fail. Sometimes we give in to something very low and we lose something very precious. And I want to encourage you today, brothers and sisters, in this beginning of the year, as you know that heaven is a beautiful place, and I look forward to that day, especially now that I see that my dad is having a stroke. He's going through a depressive. He's depressed now, friends. He refused to drink milk. He refused many times. And it's tough for my mother. I wish I can have a job in Miri at this point of time to be with them. It's tough. But the hope is that because of the promise that God has given us, that beautiful place called heaven, will be no more pain and suffering, no more stroke, no more cancer. I would not want to fall into the deal of Satan. No matter what, God help me to choose Jesus, who has done so much, to path that way so that I can go home soon to be with Jesus, friends. Today, I want to ask you a question. Would you rather choose Jesus or the deal of the devil? Today, if you would like to choose Jesus in your life and you would like God to help you, can I see your hands? Praise the Lord, Pastor. I would like to invite the worship leader to sing this song, I'd Rather Have Jesus. Can we say amen to the Lord? Amen. Thank you.
Father, that song that we have sung will be meaningless without your help. Today, we rather have you than the world. We rather have your heart rather than the attraction of the world. The time is short, Father, and help us to realize it's not going to be long from now that we will all go home to that place. Father, including myself, we may have been guilty of falling to the deal of Satan. It's not too late. Today we ask, through the power of the Holy Spirit, you'll change us. As we come out of this place, as we go to our homes and meet different peoples, the reflection of Christ will be manifested in a wonderful way in our lives, because we ask you to change us. Renew us, O Lord, as we march towards Zion. Thank you for the message of Moses, the hero who stood firm, who obeyed God, who did not fall into the deal of Pharaoh,
that represents the devil. Today, we want to recommit our lives to you. We want to be reminded that this world is not our home, that we are just a passing through. Father, today, you know our hearts. Maybe some of us here today are going through very, very difficult times in their lives. Financially, in their studies, in their relationships, in their health. But all of these, we can come to you because you are the great physician that heals our wounds. Father, help us to depend on you daily and not to look to us. Help us to look to you. Help us to lift up your name. Whatever things we do, we will be the people which is not going to be easily bought or sold. Father, today, this wonderful congregation, bless them in a wonderful way, O Lord. Not just ordinary blessings, but blessings from heaven that will follow them throughout this week. I want to especially pray for the leadership of the church, especially Pastor Mark and his family. As a pastor, I realize that it's not an easy task. I pray that wisdom, love will be with him and his family as they lead this church. Oh Lord, I pray for families here. As myself, I know that there are some family members who are not ready, who are not there yet. Please, oh Lord, help. Intervene in a divine way. You know, among us, perhaps, family members who are not at the church yet, who are not accepting yet, help them, O Lord. Nothing is impossible with you. It is a joy to come to church, that we can come and pray and ask, because you are God who hears and answers prayer according to your will. And Lord, we want to empty ourselves so that the Holy Spirit can fill us today, that we'll be able to live a Spirit-filled life. Lord, today's worship is not complete if you don't take charge of us. Do a surgery in us, O Lord. Search our hearts, so that you make us right according to your will. We thank you for Jesus, who has died for us. Thank you for the grace. We look to him. We love him. That's why we want to obey you, O Lord. Father, thank you so much for what you have done. Help us to be united in these end times. United in your glory. United in your love. So that we will always stand firm until the end. Father, today, may the love of the Father, the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit, and the grace which is so amazing from Jesus Christ will fill us and will make us anew again today. And this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.